enjoy Miyazaki's humor.
Every forest has only one wako, so one wako protects one forest. Wakos are one of the oldest species on the planet, but even older than forests. They are always friendly and chilled, and they take care about all the creatures in the forest, not even just plants, but also all the animals.
Time, so it's not just the top of the mountains that's covered with snow, but you can see drops of ice on the top of the grass field, the little grasses, frozen.
On the west side of this huge grass field, there's a very big, very old forest.
So when you walk on this grass, on these meadows, you can hear and feel it crack under your bare feet.
At the edge of that forest, there is a small wooden cabin. It fits about one or two people. It's very old. The wood feels like it has started to fall apart and that no one has been repairing it over the years.
So there's a stream from the mountains. It's now frozen. And it goes through this mill, this water mill. Of course, now in winter time, closed down.
As this river comes down, it goes in two different branches, one to the east, one to the west, passing right next to the cabin.
In the middle of these two rivers is a temple. And in this temple, we are living several monks.
Well, the grass plain, there are several places where there's large rocks, seemingly misplaced. Those rocks are called Kitoro.
Not only the rocks are called Kitoro, the whole area of is called Kitoro, Kitoro Meadows.
From the bird's eye view of flying over the plains, we now zoom in to the middle of the branched rivers where we see the temple on the outside. It's made of stone and it's covered in those little colored flags. All around the temple, it hangs. And because it's winter, there's little bits of ice on the flags.
Right at the entrance of the temple, when we look at it from far, you can see two sculptures. These are the protector of the temple.
Next to the left sculpture, there's a little bank that people can usually sit on it and wait if they want to enter the temple.
Both of the statues, they are covered with ice, and for their noses, there's little icicles.
You can hear the faint humming of monks inside the temple.
Thank you.
an extremely large and old birch tree.
A little girl sits under this tree.
Her name is Yuki, and she is wearing a school uniform, a traditional Japanese school uniform. It's a skirt and a white button-down shirt with a little necktie. She's also got one of those little backpacks that are less round but more square, and it's like hard-covered backpack.
You're always so hungry.
I'm so glad you gave me this.
I keep all the good ones for you.
Thank you so much, tree.
Every time someone passes by, I lift my branches so they can't get the good one.
It's nice to walk every day just underneath you and know that there's something for me. I can rely on you.
The camera follows Yuki as she runs out of the forest towards the stream. We see her running past the monk sitting outside of the temple, and we see her cross a bridge over the East River towards an abandoned house, or what we think is an abandoned house, on the other side of that river.
Good to keep your grandmother waiting.
I'm sorry, Grandma. I will never keep you waiting again. This is the best soup I've ever had.
Thank you.
as the smell of soup exits the window, gets out and starts flying around, goes around the grass fields, and turns towards the forest, we see the monk wandering in the forest.
Playing with the mill, slowly turning, even though it's ice open, creaks off.
Ah, Yuki, you play with the mill.
Yeah. Yes, Yuko-san.
Did I tell you the story of the little girl who used to come here and play with the mill?
No. What about her?
If the mill stops moving, the winter will never pass. Be careful. The ghost of the mill is a sensitive woman. She doesn't like too much pressure.
Oh, okay.
Be gentle.
I will.
Thank you.
Window and flies over the grass fields between the grass, separating the grass, following all the way through the forest and ends up in the old mill where an old lady is alone.
I'm getting older and older. Good news. Oh, I can eat! by the spirit of the mill. She looks ill to me. She looks really ill.
I came here with a similar problem. I was in the forest, and the creatures in the forest are behaving strange. Something happened.
Leave the mirror. The camera follows them, following the river. Until we come to the temple. There's Yuki looking at the statues.
So we've got the spit screen.
The camera pans around so you can see his face.
You see a spit screen of Yuki sitting in front of the temple, and the old lady and the monk going to the temple.
Okay. I'm scared, but I'll solve it.
That's the same fruit you always give me.
Oh, of course it is.
In the distance of the forest, we hear a faint rumbling sound as if a tree is falling down.
There you go, Yuki.
But the two forests are still. No!
As Yuki is running, we see that behind her, the birch tree is fading into the background. And as the camera turns around and follows Yuki down the forest, we see the forest getting darker and darker and denser and denser.
Thank you, Martin. Check it.